Ever since Lin-Manuel Miranda burst onto the scene with his debut musical In the Heights, he has been innovating in theatrical and movie musicals by fusing show tunes with hip-hop in his own unique way. Miranda's Broadway raps have brought some bold new sounds to the stage, and he is consistently pushing his art forward. Miranda's calling card is his world-changing hip-hop musical, Hamilton, an American Musical, one of the most important theatrical works of the 2010s. But Hamilton is one piece of an impressive and ever-growing body of work. Ever since his earliest work, he's been taking massive strides to change the public perception of hip-hop and musicals. Next, fans will get to enjoy some new sounds from Manuel as he stars in the animated adventure film Vivo. To celebrate Miranda's status as a multi-hyphenate talent of music and acting, here's a look back at how he changed the game in hip-hop, from Hamilton to Vivo. Miranda began experimenting with hip-hop and musical theater while growing up in Upper Manhattan, which later became the setting of In the Heights and parts of Hamilton. Miranda absorbed musical theater influences from his Broadway-loving father and developed a love of hip-hop thanks to his older sister. He made cassette mixtapes for his friends, which helped prepare him for Broadway by teaching him how to control the flow of a long musical suite. He began writing musicals in high school. In 2003, while in early rehearsals for In the Heights, Miranda co-created an improvisational comedy hip-hop group called Freestyle Love Supreme. The rotating members of the group, which includes rappers, singers, beatboxers, and musicians, combine off-the-dome freestyle rap with theatrical improvised comedy. In the Heights opened on Broadway in 2008 and launched its young star to new heights of his own. The play won Tonys for Best Musical, Best Original Score, Best Choreography, and Best Orchestrations, and Miranda was nominated for his performance as well. The world took notice of how surprising and delightful what Miranda was doing felt, and critics praised his rhythmic stylings in the performance. More than a decade later, In the Heights continued to be an influential work and was released as a film, starring Hamilton breakout Anthony Ramos. Hamilton, the operatic historical musical about America's first Treasury Secretary Alexander Hamilton that Miranda wrote and stars in, became an international sensation when it hit Broadway in 2015. Critics heaped praise on the production, and it was so popular with audiences that tickets to the musical remain extremely hot commodities. Hamilton won just about every major theatrical award it could have, including the Pulitzer Prize. But its true legacy is not just in the awards it won, but in the ways it changed what seemed possible. By telling a story about America's founding fathers through rap, and with an almost entirely non-white cast portraying these noteworthy figures, Hamilton reminded the world that American history belongs to American people of color, too. And that's not even mentioning how emotionally affecting the performances are, and how dazzling the dense and intelligent lyrics are. The fact that something like Hamilton exists at all is revolutionary.
It's a concept album about the life of someone I think embodies hip-hop, Treasury Secretary Alexander Hamilton.
I say the premise of the thing and everyone laughs. And I'm like, no, this is a fucking good idea. Let me just finish it. Let me just finish it. Let me show you what I mean. Let me show you what's in my head.
Miranda's mixtape-making prowess came full circle in 2016 with the Hamilton Mixtape, a compilation of Hamilton songs covered and remixed by leading rappers and pop singers. The mixtape proves that the songs of Hamilton aren't simply show tunes that can't exist outside of the context of the play. They're also genuine pop songs that could be played on the radio. The mixtape's most standout example of how hip-hop and R&B is in the DNA of Hamilton is singer Ashanti and rapper Ja Rule's duet on Helpless. Miranda told Entertainment Weekly that when he was writing Helpless, he was inspired by Ashanti and Ja Rule's early classics like Always on Time and Mesmerize. Because it's written as an Ashanti and Ja Rule song, he and the mixtape's other producers didn't really consider anyone else for the new version. The result feels like a lost MTV hit from 2002. We've seen a lot of pop songs get adapted into Broadway musicals, but not often the other way around, which is another testament to the fact that Lin-Manuel Miranda is always busy changing the hip-hop game.
Vivo, what are you doing?
I don't know, but sometimes you gotta improvise.
You can catch Miranda next in the animated film Vivo. Miranda composed original songs for the film and provides the voice of the title character, a musical kinkajou, a rainforest mammal also known as a honey bear, who goes on a journey to the faraway land of Miami to deliver a musical love song from his best friend Andres to his long-lost love Marta Sandoval. with the help of a quirky girl named Gabby. Lin-Manuel Miranda previously nabbed an Academy Award nomination for his work on Moana, but Vivo marks the first time Miranda has had the lead role in an animated film. Blending musical theater with hip-hop and Latin music in a way that only Miranda could, combined with a heartwarming story of love and family, Vivo is a toe-tapping family adventure that proves Lin-Manuel Miranda is still changing the game.
And the journey begins now!
Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.